For another day. Ooh-wee. Let me be quiet and introduce our host for today, Elder Gail Pinkney.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome. And thank you for being here once again for another Mount Moriah Community Church virtual service brought to you by Zoom. We know that it is not by chance, accident, or coincidence that brought you here this morning. It is our holy God that has brought you here this day to hear what thus says the Lord. I know God has a word for each and every one of us, so don't go home without it. Have an ear to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. The Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silence before him. Habakkuk 2 and 20.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. Amen.
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 Elder Gail, you want to talk a little bit about what this month has been all about? Sorry, I'm a little emotional.
Oh, well, this month has been about 20 years of fighting spiritual warfare. And I'm sorry, I'm waiting for my husband to give me that write-up that he did for the 20 years. And it's about putting on the full armor of God and what the number 20 represents in the Bible, and it symbolizes the cycles of completeness, redemption, and perfection. And it also represents the year of expectancy just before the year 21, or the trifold completeness of 3 7-year periods. In addition, the number 20 conveys a meaning of a perfect period of waiting, labor, or suffering that is compared to a trial and rewarded. If it is successfully completed, the reward is generous and full of God's love. For example, 20 years Jacob waited to gain possession of his wife Rachel's property and to be freed from the control of Laban, his father-in-law. A combination of 20 years, Solomon was waiting for the completion of both the temple and his palace. It took 7 years to build the house of God in Jerusalem and another 13 years building his own home, which made up the 30 years. And 20 years, Israel waited for deliverance until Samson became judge, and he was judge over Israel for the period of 20 years. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you so much. And Elder Gail, I don't know if we mentioned this already, but this is the last Sunday that we're celebrating 20 years. And so we have just learned from what you have read that 20 is not just a random number. There is some very strong significance. So well done, thy good and faithful servant.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, yes. We are going to go into our announcement. We only have a few. Coming up, we've got Women of Favor. Who is a woman of favor? A blessed woman on Zoom today. I know I'm blessed and highly favored. And we have a treat because the woman behind Women of Favor is our host today. So do you want to give us a little bit more information about what's coming up?
Yes, our Women of Favor, as you can see on the screen, it is every fourth Tuesday at 7 p.m. where women come out, and it's a time for us to gather together for gospel-centered encouragement from God's word, as well as a topic of interest to women from the comfort of your own home. All are invited to join us for a time of fellowship and fun. You don't have to be a member of Mount Moriah Community Church, which we would love for you to be, but if you're not, you can still come and enjoy. And the title, the lesson/discussion that we will be having on the 27th is Prayers and Decrees to Guard Our Schools from Evil Attacks. So those who have children, I invite you to come and listen and just enjoy what, you know, what we God has to share with all of us. Okay?
Amen. Thank you so much, Elder Gail. What a treat to have you here. And speaking of treats, who is ready to come back again tonight at 4 p.m.? Stay tonight. Amen. We have our closing service this evening with our very special guest, our Bishop Michael Gardenhire from Newcastle Baptist Church, which is our sister church. So we encourage you to come and close out right with all of us, because it will be a beautiful service with an awesome word. And if you're going to join us, make sure you bring a friend. We're on Zoom. The link will be accessible to you. It's the same link that you used to get on here today, but we'll also put it on the website, which is mountmoriahcc.com. And if you have not given a love offering to our pastor or our special guest, there's still time. And here's the information to give a little something special, extra special, for our speaker for this evening. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to myself, Dr. D, and Elder Rhonda for more information. Amen.
Amen.
Speaking of giving, who loves to give?
Amen.
All right. Okay. I see some hands up. Well, there are several ways that you can give to this ministry through Zelle or Giftify. And you can also mail your payment. But don't forget to include Mount Moriah Community Church on any checks that you write. There are 20 reasons I can think of off the top of my head. And I bet you, depending on your week, you've got 20 more to add to that list. So I'm not going to read this list, but no, there are so many reasons why we all should give to God's place of worship. Amen. First and foremost, he wants us to be obedient and it shows love. So let's continue to show love. Amen. Yeah. All right. Well,
we will now have our scripture reading from our own Elder Roy Stewart.
Amen. Well, good morning.
Good morning.
And thank you there. Be reading from the King James Version, Ephesians chapter 6, verses 10 through 18. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all to stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching therefore with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. Amen.
Amen. Amen. We will now have our morning prayer by Elder Lamario Pinckney.
Can you hear me?
We're getting some feedback.
You got to turn yours down.
I'm unmuted.
You have to mute it.
I'm muted.
Put the volume down on you.
Turn it down just a little bit.
Sorry about that. That's my fault.
Okay. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Devil's busy this morning, isn't he?
Yes.
That's all right. That's all right.
Hey, but guess what? We're going to get through this.
Amen.
The Lord has something prepared for us, I know. Let us go before the Lord in prayer. Amen. Lord, we just thank you once again, Father God, for allowing us to come before you in prayer. And with expectancy in our heart, Father God. Lord, we know that you've got a word prepared for us. We know that your servant is ready to serve us, Father God, another helping of the buffet that you've already prepared for us this month, Lord God, in preparing us to take up the whole armor, to be prepared and ready for war. Lord, we just thank you for the word that's going to come forth. We thank you, Father God, that it will fall on hearts that can receive it and minds that will comprehend, Lord God. And Lord, we just thank you, Father God, that your servant will bring forth your word with power and might and with the Holy Spirit leading and guiding her, Father God. We know that the anointing will fall. We expect it, Lord God, and we already know in your word that how beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel of peace and bring glad tidings of good things according to your word. We know that your servant, Elder Rhonda, will bring forth your word and prepare us and prepare our feet to stand against the wiles of the enemy. And Lord, we thank you, we praise you, we give you glory and we give you honor. Right now, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen, 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 and amen.
Amen.
Ooh, we 20. Ooh, Elder Gale.
Can you mute?
Amen. Turn down your volume just a little bit for me because I'm getting feedback from you too. Can you say something? Yep, there you go.
Okay.
Yes, you want to tell us about some of these stories behind your pictures?
Oh, yes. I'm going to start off with the one on the bottom left. This was a visit from my dear cousin and his sister, Elder Rhonda, to South Carolina. And I can't say how old Pastor was, but at this point, I know I was in my 20s. So, I mean, what a joy for this to be presented, because neither one of us at this point, and he could answer that, but neither one of us at this point thought that we would be in the ministry and on Zoom on, I can't even come up with the words, you know, to be present this day in ministry together from Georgia and New York. My goodness. Is Pastor there? I can't see him. Is he there?
No, he had to step away.
Mm-hmm. That's okay. That's part of right. He'll be back in a minute to say something about it. But the one on the right was when Elder Mel and I were dating. So this is when my hair was long. And that's the other picture you saw when he was hosting was how it looks, you know, when I roll it or whatever. This is a blow dry, so anyway. But I do have a few personal 20 stories during this time. When I was in my 20s, I was Miss Alpha Phi Alpha at Fable State University, which meant a lot to me because Pastor John's uncle and my uncle, John Boone, was an Alpha. And I also pledged Alpha Kappa Alpha and graduated from college in my 20s. I bought my first car, which was a stick shift, and I didn't know how to drive it off the lot. And a friend of mine who I would bowl with, her brother went with me. And, you know, I was jerking all the way, all the way to the bowling alley because, you know, we had bowling after work. So that was for me today to think that I would have done that, you know, I mean, that's pretty bold to buy a car you don't even know how to drive. So you all think I'm crazy. Hey, I didn't have anybody to teach me. So I taught myself how to drive a stick shift. So I also have my own apartment. I got married at 26 years of age and I gave birth to two of our children in my 20s. So.
Well, I got to say, y'all look like a picture perfect couple in this. I'm looking at this like y'all needed to have a show or be on some commercial or something. I would have completely signed up for that dating app if there was an app back in that day. If well, y'all were on there.
He was actually a blind date.
Oh, I love it.
Yeah, and I would have never thought I would have gone on a blind date. But yeah, my job would send me to the bank and it was a fellow banker there that, you know, called me over and asked me questions. And he said he had a friend that was a fellow banker and could he give him my number? And that's how it started. And because I would have never, you know, that it just happened that way. God had it that way.
What was up with blind dates back in the day? You know, Elder Roy knows about blind dates too.
Alrighty.
That's how he met his wife.
Oh my goodness. That's another thing we all have in common. My goodness.
We can't do blind dates now, I don't think.
I don't think so. I don't think I could do it today either. And he took forever to call, but he finally did call, and that's how we met on a blind date. Yeah.
I love it. I love it. Well, Elder Gail, I'm curious to know about this picture right above yours, about this cute family.
Oh, wow. Yes.
First Lady?
Well, I'll be glad to fill in for Pastor. This actually was our first anniversary. Well, at least for Pastor John as being pastor of Mount Moriah Community Church. So that was our first celebration of him being pastor. And as you can see, the three munchkins there, there's Andre, and there's Austin, who is probably crying, but and there is Chloe. So that's 20 years ago, to be exact, and how time has flown. Everyone is grown. Andre is married. Austin is in graduate school. And today is actually Chloe's birthday.
Yes.
That's right, September 25th. She is actually 21 years old. So she was 1 year old at that in that picture there. So, wow, time really flies. I remember that so well. And that was just a wonderful day for us as pastor and wife, as well as a family. And so I'm just grateful for how God has kept us these 20 years. In the ministry, wow, I'm just like taken back over that fact, but just kept us as a family. And so that I am forever grateful for that. And so it's just wonderful to see all the pictures here and the throwbacks and it's just been wonderful. The last 20 years, we've had ups and downs. That's for sure. But I just thank God for his keeping power. And yes, fighting the good fight of faith, the spiritual warfare, the prayers and the fasting. Oh my goodness. Where will we be without the fasting and the prayers and without you, your support? Some of the people here have been with us way over 20 years. And I'm so grateful for that. And I'm looking forward to the new beginnings of our new family who have joined us here at Mount Moriah Community Church. 20 more years. Amen. 20 more years. Amen. I look forward to that. So God is good. God is good. And oh, I see Pastor John. I hope I didn't talk too long. He's making his way. He's making his way this way, and just give him a half a second. Here he comes.
Oh my.
I know.
Pokey smoke. Yeah.
Well, I just spoke about us, and they just spoke about Elder Gail shared about those moments. So I don't know if you remember. How old were you, Pastor John? In that picture with Elder Gail.
I think I was 17.
Yeah.
No way. I think I was in my 20s. And you know, I have no idea who snapped this picture.
Yeah, neither do I.
But to let the church know, that hug that you see with us being girls, just six girls, when we saw our boy cousins, we were all over them.
So
that's a perfect example right there of how much, you know, we love to see, because we, you know, the one brother that we did have, you know, he was born a year before I was, and he died when he was 6 months old of pneumonia, and his name was Franklin Gibbs McCray. And when I came the next year, I looked so much like him, is why they named me Francine Gail McCray, so that I could have my dad's initials. So, they would call me Gail and only call me Francine when I got
trouble. Wow.
So.
Wow.
Didn't know that. Thanks for that tidbit. Wow.
Well, I do know that that picture was taken when we went down to bury our grandfather.
Oh, during that time?
Yeah. So that means that was in the 70s. We went down, I was staying at, what's his name? Emerson's house.
Oh, yes.
And I remember there was another group of pictures that were taken with my mother, mm-hmm. a friend down the road from where Granddad used to live. I don't remember her name, but also Angela's mom. Mm-hmm. So they had come into St. Stephen, I guess. Well, I don't know, because that's right. The funeral was at the old Clapboard Church in St. Stephen. That's where our grandparents, you know, fellowshipped at that why am I skipping my memory here?
That's all right.
Well, anyway,
at that 20 plus years ago, it's okay.
Yeah, okay, yeah, right.
But that's I remember a couple of those pictures taken. Like Gail said, who took them? I have no idea, but thank God somebody took them.
And, well, let me tell you, I gotta point this some. Out. You got hair.
Yeah,
you got your hair.
A lot.
Yeah, that's
and it was all brown.
Yeah, definitely in the 70s. Yeah, grew the hair very long. But not long enough for a ponytail. I was not going to be into no ponytails, nothing like that. It was just
they call them man buns now.
Yeah. Man buns.
Yeah. It was just fluff, as you can see.
Amen.
But Pastor,
while you were away, I made a statement that who would have thought at that point that we both would have been in ministry and where we are right now.
Yeah, how true. Yeah. How true.
You know, I tell full circle, that's for sure.
Yeah. Right.
And you know what? Right. I remember when we were at the church burying my mom, when we went down to bury my mom, I remember Gail walking up to the casket. And saying goodbye to my mom. And I'll never forget that. I mean, it's not like we were down there very often, but the mere fact that she was, I guess her mother, my mother, they were sisters. Mm-hmm. And to be honest with you, they looked more like twins than my mother and Uncle Pete. They didn't look like twins, but Gail's mom and my mom, they looked like they would be twins because they had the round, pudgy face, you know. But anyway, it was just one of those moments, I should say. Okay.
Amen.
You know, Pastor, it's amazing that you just said that, because with me not knowing that, Cynthia's twin, Sylvia, always says to me, Gail, you and I look more like twins than my own twin. So.
Yeah.
Goodness gracious.
It's true. It's true.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Well, thank y'all so much. And we actually have a question, don't we?
Oh,
another pastor and first lady.
I do. All right. But you know what? I couldn't decide which one. So I wrote them all down. So you have to pick a question between 1 to 5.
Okay.
Now we got a word coming now. Wait a minute.
No. They're not going to answer all this. I couldn't make up my mind. I couldn't make up my mind which one to ask.
I
wrote them down, and they're going to pick which one between 1 to 5.
Gotcha.
Okay, so can we pick a number? Pick a number?
Yes.
We'll go in the middle, 3.
Mm. All right. Well, number 3 says, aside from the Bible, what other book has most influenced your life?
Ooh.
Now, if you don't really read a whole lot of books, we don't have to do this question.
No. This has always been, not because it's my name, but I always enjoyed this book, St. John.
You mean a book in the Bible?
Yeah.
No,
I said
a book outside from the Bible.
A book outside? Oh, right. I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Hmm.
What other book has most influenced your life?
Oh boy, gee.
Yeah, that's why I said if you don't read a lot of books, we could do a different question, because I don't read a whole lot of other books other than the Bible. So if you want a different question, we can.
Yeah, not lately.
Well, no, I have read few books in my life only because I'm not really a reader per se. in that respect, I became a reader in the Bible, but not of books. But the book that stands out in my mind is a book named Giants in the Earth.
Okay. What's that about?
Yeah. Well, the title doesn't pretty much tell what it is. You think giants, you might think dinosaurs or big people, but no. It has to do with almost like the Grapes of Wrath, poor family trying to make it, and how they were able to get through their struggles.
Amen.
Oh. And maybe because I could relate to it, I kept reading.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
But very interesting. That's the book that stands out to me.
Well, as he was speaking, a book that came to mind was a book that I believe I think we had purchased it for Andre. It's called Make Your Bed. I forget the name of the author, but he was Andre can help me out with this. He was in the, I think a Navy SEAL or something like that.
Yeah, he was an ex-Navy SEAL.
Right. And Make Your Bed, basically, in a nutshell, because we spent a lot of time, or me talking earlier, but Make Your Bed is about just having principles and how no matter whatever you do, do it to your best, and to make everything counts, even making your bed. That was the purpose of the title. So whatever you do, whatever you say, how you live, make a difference, because people are watching you, and how your life is an example of who you are. And as Christians, what I took from that, because it wasn't really a spiritual or from a Christian standpoint, but how your life, what you say and do, can be so influential on others. And so whatever you do, make it count, because people are watching you. So
that's so true.
I love that book.
Amen. Well, thank you so much, Pastor and First Lady.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
All right, so now it's time for a testimony, songs, and a favorite scripture. Amen.
Oh, I see Andre's hand is up.
Amen.
Well, I figure I start things off, I guess. Grateful, to God for being here, thankful to be able to, pretty much see the end of, the past anniversary. It was definitely really cool seeing those throwbacks, because I know that recent picture of the first pastor's anniversary, I actually do remember slightly. I remember Austin actually was crying that picture. I do remember that. But, it was really nice seeing those throwbacks, just kind of like seeing through time, through, me growing up through that and experiencing, all the many years and stuff. Also, speaking of years, grateful for the fact today is me and Lindsay's second, wedding anniversary.
Happy anniversary.
Oh. It's only, granted, we don't have that many years. I know many got 40 years under their belt. We're just starting out, but I'm grateful for those 2 years that God's blessed for us being together.
Amen.
And stuff. Also, I want to let everyone know that this will be the last time you guys will see me before I go for my deployment. So, I know for a fact that, through the prayers and everything, all the just the support from you guys, I know will take me through the next 6 months. I'm over in Africa, and he'll keep me safe. I mean, he's kept me safe here in the States with how, I guess, dangerous my job is here and stuff. And I know he'll keep me safe over there as well, but don't worry. I mean, I know God will make a way to where I'll be able to attend the service. They do have some form of Wi-Fi over there, so I might be calling at 3 a.m. where it's like 11 o'clock over here, but I'll definitely do my best to try to attend you know, the service and let you guys know how I'm doing. But overall, I'm happy to be here, you know, grateful to see the rest of the service.
Amen. Thank you, Andre.
Amen. All right. Chloe and Austin?
Psalm 103:13. Like as a father, hideth his children, the Lord hideth them that fear him.
Hosea 14:1-2. O Israel, return unto the Lord thy God, for thou hast fallen by thine iniquity. Take with you words and turn to the Lord, saying to him, take away all iniquity and receive us graciously. So will we render the calves of our lips.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Hey, I don't know what you think, Elder Gail, but Chloe reads that like a real 21-year-old.
Hey, hallelujah.
Happy birthday, Chloe.
Yes, sweet girl.
And thank you both, Austin and Chloe. Yes, absolutely. We've got Sister Spool unmuted.
Yes.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Blessing yourself.
Can you hear me?
Be loud and clear.
Yes, I thank the Lord for today. I thank the Lord for allowing my life to allowing me to live, because yesterday I know I had such a headache, and I never had that headache before. But I thank the Lord for still being here in the house of the Lord. And I thank the Lord, my healer, and he is my everything. And I thank the Lord for Pastor John and the First Lady. I thank the Lord, Sister and Elder Picnic. I thank the Lord to send the word on last Sunday. Thank the Lord for the beautiful word. You know, it's beautiful because he's God, is God. And beside there is none other. And I thank the Lord for he give us grace, give us sight, and give us the hearing, give us the understanding to praise him, because he's the one that give us all the benefit. He have all the benefit. And I thank the Lord for in anything you ask in his name, he give it to you. Hallelujah. He's not like a human. Humans, sometimes they neglect because they think you don't need it, or you don't, you know, just be asking. But when you ask God, he'll give it to you. He knows where you want it or not. It is necessary to give it to you. And I thank the Lord for he's so sweet and so wonderful. To praise. And I thank the Lord for the nice, wonderful picture that you can, where you took, you know, when you're young, you can see and you say you're glad to see them now. You know what the Lord will prepare you for. And I thank the Lord for he's wonderful. He knows everything, and I'm so glad that he do, you know, and he don't hold back on anything. He's so sweet and nice, and he give it to you and according to his word. He say he give it, you know, he give it, and he take away things that gonna harm you, and he stand there waiting to say thank you. Hallelujah. We owe him all the praise. And I thank the Lord for today. I thank the Lord for Cynthia. I thank the Lord for all of them in serving today. Thank the Lord for to see another anniversary. Thank the Lord for him seeing another anniversary. Thank the Lord for from the beginning, I just loved him, you know, and prayed for him. He knows that I prayed for him, and I thank the Lord, you know, one night, you know, when he was sick, you know, I just prayed and get on my knees and prayed, and I just fell asleep on my knees, you know. When I got up from the prayer, you know, it didn't feel like it used to feel when you get down on your knees and pray, and you get up, you'd be hurting. But that time I wasn't hurting. I said, thank you, Jesus, because I stayed down there all night long, you know, and I fell asleep. And I thank the Lord for giving me the grace to get up, walk, and have active and live in my mind. Hallelujah, because I was praying to him to ask him, hallelujah, to heal those that are sick and afflicted tonight. Hallelujah, that's on our pastor, John Shepherd. And I thank the Lord for how he committed right to him. And I thank the Lord for grace and mercy. Thank the Lord for the son, hallelujah. And he got married. And thank the Lord for his wife, hallelujah. Thank the Lord for the people coming all good. Hallelujah, we have to bring all from our parents. We got to get Jesus for ourselves. And I thank the Lord for you have the privilege to get Jesus for yourself. Hallelujah. It don't matter how long you praise him. It don't matter how long it takes to praise him to stand in the gap. Don't move. Hallelujah. But continue. Stand there for Jesus. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's the one. Hallelujah. You ask for him. Hallelujah. You ask him anything. He'll tell you and he'll give you an answer. Whether you like the answer or not. But you have decided for yourself. God is able, hallelujah, to supply all your need according to the riches and glory. Just pray my strength and Lord for our sister Dee. We thank the Lord for her. Hallelujah, you've done a beautiful job. I thank for Elder Roy. I thank the Lord for praying for him. Hallelujah, that he may be sanctified. Hallelujah, as he is. Hallelujah, I know he lost his wife, but God will supply his need. Hallelujah. Every time he asks him, God, everything given to him. In the name of Jesus. Pray my strength in the Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. Thank you. Amen. You know, Elder Gail, I know we go a long time with testimony service, but I gotta add this little piece of historic information. Right, because let me tell you something. That woman right there, Sister Sproul, I remember you, Sister Sproul. In your deacon outfit. Yes, I do. I remember you in the brick and mortar. I remember. So you are one of the gifts.
Amen.
How
Amen.
Long have you been in Mount Moriah? Amen. You got to mute yourself, Sister Sproul. Come on. You did it. You just did it. You can do it again. I believe in you. We can't hear you. Okay, we're going to get your story later. But we... That is a treasure.
Amen. Oh, Amen. Can I add in? My mom would probably know how long she's been there because as I've been there all my life. So, right. And me, when you get to a point where you kind of understand who people are, I would have to say at least 60 something years.
Wow.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah. She is one of the cornerstones.
Cornerstones. Amen.
Amen.
Literally.
There's several.
I just want to thank and praise God for Deaconess Spiel too, because her testimony was right on time. Mm. I'm going to make this short. She started off by saying that God will answer your prayers even when you just think a thought. Well, I was walking the other day and I was just thinking a thought. And the first thing that God did for me is I told God that I wanted a BMW because it reminds me of my initials, Boone McRae Wright. My mother was a Boone, I was a McRae, and I'm married to a Wright, okay? Now, I don't really like foreign cars anymore because they're too expensive to get fixed, but guess what? There's a candy apple red BMW sitting outside in front of my house in my name.
Praise the Lord.
I'm giving God the praise for that.
Praise the Lord.
Yesterday, I think it was Friday, I was walking in the neighborhood because I was trying to walk every day, but sometimes I miss. But I was walking. Okay, I gave my son-in-law my expensive desk, okay, a $500 desk. I let him have it. So I was walking in the neighborhood, and I spotted another beautiful desk that somebody had thrown out. I was just sitting on the curb. And I said, Lord, that is a nice looking desk. Mm-hmm. I sure would like to have that desk to replace the one that I gave away. But I don't know how I would get it and how I would get it to the house because I don't have the means to get it to the house. Guess what? Soon as I got home, my son-in-law went and brought that desk to my house.
Amen.
And I didn't expect him to do it.
Praise the Lord.
But I mean, I was just thinking the thought, and God did it. That's all I have to say. Glory be to God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Did I see Mother Lenny Parks on mute?
Well, yes, I.
Well, hello. Good morning. Another look. Well, the original mother. The original.
All right. I can listening, but I tell you, I couldn't sit by and not say nothing because 20 years of my life is gone.
That's right.
We thank God for my son-in-law, for how blessing he has been to our family and to my daughter. And to I thank God for him taking over like he did. I mean, I tell you, it's something else to, I can't even put it into words, but I thank God for him. And I thank God for all of them, the beautiful pictures of the young people when they were young.
Yeah.
But see, it goes to show you have matured.
Yeah.
You know what I want to do say about Sister Sproul? She has been faithful.
Amen.
She is a faithful trooper. You hear me? She came all the way from Jersey on the by herself driving those many years. And I tell you what, the people that lived nearby was always late to church, but you know she was never late.
Hallelujah.
Now that's faithful sister.
Yes.
We think of her. Thank God. I love her very much, and I miss seeing her, but God knows what he's doing. But one day we're going to get back together.
Alrighty now.
We may get back to the brick border, maybe. But it's up to God. We thank God for our brother Mario Pickney and his wife. Mm-hmm. And I love the way he breaks. He knows his history and he knows how to put it together. I thank God for that. You have a blessed husband, and I know he has a blessed wife.
Thank you so much,
brother. And all the people, and I miss Sister Annie. I really do. I tell you, I was, God knows what he's doing.
Amen.
Because sometimes he takes some, and sometimes he leaves some.
Amen.
And I thank God for the life that she lived, and I showed him before I said, "Well, I'm going to leave her name on the prayer." More. I'm not taking it off because the spirit is still here. Thank the God. We thank God for all of you all, and for my happy birthday to Chloe. I'm a little late. I'm getting older. Don't remember things as well as I used to. I remembered it, but when he got to it, I slipped right
back. Yes, all right.
But God bless you. You're gonna get something in the mail. Just want you to know. We thank God for you. I thank God for our sister Rhonda being you're talking about a brick and a mortar. She has been faithful to us, and she has been there for us every step of the way. And I love her for it, because I tell you, God knows what he's doing. When he brought people in, some left, but God renewed the staff. He brought in laborers to work with us in our church. And we thank him for it. We thank God for it, because God is a good God. And thank God for the strength that our sister Letitia's having hanging in there, girl. Thank God for you. She's there in the morning. If she comes in, she comes in and says she's here, but I know she's doing things, but God knows. And I thank God for Brother Roy bless my niece, Danielle. Love you.
Amen.
God keep you and strengthen you. May God bless you.
Amen.
This is the day the Lord has made. We don't know about yesterday, but we got it going on today. We thank God for that. So you pray my strength in the Lord that he keep me. And I thank God for little Lindsay coming into our lives and for my grandson getting someone who knows the Lord. That means a lot.
Amen.
You hear me? That will.
Amen.
Thank God. We thank God for all, and thank God for all of us in this morning, for our niece Sister Wakefield, how she has come a long way. And thank God for all of us. I could go on and on. I guess shut up, please.
All right, Madeline, you go right on.
I don't usually say too much, but I tell you, I appreciate every one of you guys. And we thank God for delivering our brother John from them stones.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. That was God. That was God. We thank God. There's no damage to that liver, that kidney. We thank God for that. You pray my strength in the Lord. And I look like me and Sister Sproul is the last ones. I think the oldest ones that's left.
Hallelujah.
That's Sister Smith too.
And there is Sister Smith.
Smith and Sister Moore.
Sister Davis. And who?
Sister Moore.
Sister Moore is still here, yes. Yeah. Thank God for the ones that are faithful.
Awesome.
They've been here until day one. Right. Hear me? We thank God for the guest's blessing upon it. Continue to be strong in the Lord. As when Moses died, he said, Moses is dead. My husband died. But he put it into the right hand. He said, be strong because God is going to be with you. What will we do without John? I don't know, but we got to make a way, but I don't want to think about it. But we thank God for him and for all that he's done for us and our families. You pray my strength in the Lord in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. We love you, Mother Parks.
We love you too.
Wow, talk about history on a screen. Isn't that something? Speaking of history, is Sister Smith with us? Sister Smith, if you're there, please unmute yourself. I don't want us to miss out on anyone, but I know we got a good word. So somebody just unmute it. Sister Smith?
That was Sister Smith. I don't know what happened.
Okay. Well,
Sister
Davis.
There we go.
Okay.
Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, come upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumble and fail. Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fail. Though war should rise up against me, in this will I be confident. One thing that I have desired of the Lord, that I will seek after, that I may dwell in the house with the Lord all the days of my life, and to inquire in his temple. That's the first verse of the 27th Psalm. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine.
All right.
Oh, I told Satan, get thee behind. Victory today is mine. Oh, when I rose this morning, I didn't have no God. I know that the Lord wicked eyes. When I fell down on my knees, I said, Lord, help me, please. And I got up shouting the victory. Oh, joy is mine. Joy is mine. Joy today is mine. Oh, I told Satan, get thee behind, joy today is mine. Oh, when I rose this morning, I didn't have no doubt.
Yeah.
I know that the Lord wicked eyes. Well, I fell down on my knees. I said, Lord, help me, please. And I got up shouting the victory. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Sister Smith, thank you so much. I hope you heard all the words about the history of you all being there from the beginning.
Yes. So this afternoon, I'll see you again.
Amen. We're looking forward to it. Okay. Sister Davis, are you on?
Yes. Before this, I would like to tell a little story. I got my mail out the box yesterday, and then they said I had a Con Edison letter. So I said, why is I'm getting a Con Edison letter? Because I paid my bill on the first of the month. So when I opened it, it said none. I said, why are they telling me none when I already done paid them, right? So I opened it, and this is what happened. My bill used to be $230. So I cut down on the washing and everything yet, and then it went down to $160. That's good. I got the letter yesterday. They're going to send me $160 back, but they're supposed to send me $300 back because it say the balance that they're supposed to send me is $300, but they only going to send me $160 back in the mail one day this week, I guess. And then guess what happened? The 15th of next month, I got to pay $241. That means they're going up $82 more a month on my commercial bill, and I can't figure it out. But what they say, it's not because I'm burning, it's because of the energy price that went up on them. So we got to suffer. You know that, right? Why should I suffer? I said, oh, my God. So let me sing the song. I got a feeling everything going to be all right.
Yes.
Everything going to be all right.
Yes, it is.
I got a feeling everything's going to be all right. Be all right. Be all right, be all right. My God done told me everything's gonna be all right. Oh, my God done told me everything's gonna be all right. My God done told me everything's gonna be all right. Be all right, be all right, be all right. If you trust him, everything's gonna be all right.
Amen.
Trust him, everything gonna be all right. If you trust him, everything gonna be all right. Be all right, be all right, be all right. Love y'all.
Love you too. Love you too, Sister Davis.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, Sister Letitia's hand is up. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Praise the Lord, everyone. Pastor John, First Lady, everyone in respective places. Oh, my goodness. Sister Davis, you make us laugh. And it's such a beautiful thing because laughter soothes the soul. Because no matter what story you have, you always have a song to back it up. And it just brings joy to our soul. It's just such a representation of what Mount Moriah is, that even though we go through, we have our trials and our testimonies, there has always been laughter in the church. And that's really what I wanted to testify about today. My beginning of knowing who God was as a Jehovah Witness, actually. Thank God we were delivered from that. And I just thank God that I got saved later on in my life. And covered my children. But I grew up thinking and believing that, you know, God was just a serious, stern God, and there was no laughter, and you just, you know. And it was such a joy coming to Mount Moriah, seeing Pastor John, Pastor Parks laugh and tell little jokes on the pulpit, and then to see Pastor John come up there, and we know as quiet as he says he is, he's a comedian. So I just want to say congratulations and happy anniversary, Pastor John and First Lady. It has truly been an honor and a joy to be under you all these years. So many places I could go with that, but it's an honor to see friends that I've invited here online. to see my girl still coming back, to see my godsons coming. So just all of these years of so many generations still having an opportunity to come and get the word, I thank you. May God continue to keep you, God to strengthen you, and order your steps. I love you all, Mount Moriah. Happy birthday, Chloe. Happy anniversary, anniversary, Andre and Lindsay. Mwah.
Yes.
Yeah. God be the glory.
It's so good to hear your voice.
Yes.
So good to hear your voice.
Yes. Could I make this little remark?
Yes.
That some people have been saying to me, y'all don't have the traditional church. I said, no, why? Because we're free. are free. You hear me? We come in and we are ourselves. God loves that because we praise him naturally because we know him. Thank God for Jesus. I thank God because God said he's going to do a new thing. Church is not going to be the same anymore. We got to show that God has a laugh every day because he enjoys us, and I know he enjoys us. I thank God for that because he gave me that the other day that we are unique, you know, and we thank God. We have the word. We get the word, and we thank God for that. Now, we continue to be ourselves. Be relaxed in the Lord. Laugh sometime. It's good for souls. It's medicine. And I thank God for all of you all. We pray my strength in the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Elder Gill?
Oh, yes. All right. I didn't know if we had any more testimonies. But we do have a song that is requested by our elder, Rhonda Sheckett. And after this song is played, the next voice you will hear will be Elder Rhonda Sheckett. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Come on, put your hand together. Ooh, yeah. Listen here. Said I'm stronger than I've ever been. Oh, I'm stronger than I've ever been. You know that saying? Sing it for me one time. Come on, put those hands together. Said I'm stronger than I ever been. Can I get a witness? Anybody stronger? Stronger, listen. I did a lot of things I was ashamed of. Didn't listen to what mama taught me about my God's love. I used to be so weak, I fell for Satan's game. But Jesus came and rescued me. Now I'm not the same. Said I'm stronger. Come on, church, and put your hand together. Come on and give me a holy hand. Glory, glory, glory,
Cause if you don't, you better watch out.
Come on, baby.
Come on, baby. Lift your head.
Come on.
Let me lift your
head. Come on, now.
I better watch out.
I better watch
out.
Shut up.
Father God, in the name that's high above every name, Lord, we thank you for everything that we have heard, all of which you graced us to participate in. And oh, Father God, as Jesus is the Word made flesh, and came down to dwell among us. Oh, raise it up out of me that utterance may be given unto me to make plain known the gospel of peace. Oh, Father God, touch every listening ear, open every heart to receive the love of the truth. Those that are saved, that song we've been was stronger than we've ever been through our trials and our tribulations. Oh, Father God, you make us strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Now, in Jesus' name, our segment, our series has been on the whole armor of God. And let's see, we have done now the belt of truth, breastplate of righteousness, shield of faith, the helmet of salvation, the sword of the spirit, and I'm coming forth with the shoes of the gospel of peace, which is the word of God, which is Jesus made flesh and came down to dwell among us. Spiritual warfare is reality, yet its existence is very much a reality. It's not the natural flesh, it's spiritual. The Apostle Paul wrote to the Ephesian church, warning them about the enemy of our faith, an enemy that must be fought on a spiritual battlefield, which why he, by him being incarcerated in Rome for such a long time, he was able to observe the Roman soldier and therefore pattern for us the belt of truth, breastplate of righteousness, shield of faith, helmet of salvation, the sword of the spirit, which we know is the word of God, and the shoes, amen, which the Lord will bless me to elaborate on. We want to thank God in Romans 10:15, how beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel of peace and bring glad tidings of good things, amen. And with your feet fitted with the readiness, in other words, you're prepared. I like that word readiness because, in other words, by us being born again, saved, do we carry our tracts with us? So wherever we go, if we're on the bus stop, if we're walking through the street, if we're in the grocery store, the pharmacy, wherever we are, we have a mind that's ready to distribute, to lay out, to present the word of God, the gospel, amen. We can do that by giving out tracts. We can do that by lending a helping hand, amen. All of this is having the readiness that comes from the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ. The shoes worn by the Roman warrior generally came in a sandal variety. They had thick leather soles that were studded. That's like, if we use a comparison, cleats that let's see, the football player, the baseball player, use as they play their game. Ours is the true game of life, actually. But this Roman soldier had these studded sandals, so it kept their feet anchored down, solid, steadfast, which God wants us to be. Steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that our labor is not in vain, not wishy-washy, not falling to the right side or to the left. Amen. We're solid for his glory. Amen. It says also the sandals came up above the ankle and were held securely to the foot by extensive leather straps. In other words, you don't want to have your gear on where it's going to rattle or shake or fall apart because your life is at stake. And so it is even when we're presenting the gospel. We have examples in scripture, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They stood fast, amen. That fourth man that was in the fiery furnace was Jesus, amen. And they stood fast. They stood fast, even though that's Old Testament. They stood fast as an example, even though they were in the fiery furnace. They didn't get burned up because Jesus was right there with them. They stood for what they believed in, amen. Thank God also to survive cold weather climate. Soldiers would fill the sandal with heavy wool or fur before lacing up. In some cases, Roman commanders would wear an early version of a boot. It had a thick leather sole and was either split down the front or on either side to allow entry. Straps were sewn to the back and wrapped up the leg to hold the boot securely. Jesus is our preparation and peace. Without Jesus in your life, you have no peace. You could have $1 million and then your world is going upside down turmoil. You can be sick and still have billions or millions of dollars where the world would consider you have no worries. But unless Jesus is in your soul or in your heart, you have no peace. You can have everything falling apart around you. When Jesus walked on that water and that storm hit the disciples, and the storm hit on the water, amen. All Jesus had to say was, peace, be still. And that same spill, that same peace is still available for us today. But in order to have it, you must be born again. Born again. Hallelujah. Without his sandals, a soldier would not be prepared to fight and could be easily defeated. Paul tells us that our preparation for battle is the good news, meaning the gospel of Jesus Christ, the life of Jesus, death and resurrection. The work of Jesus here on earth brought us peace with God. This reconciliation through Jesus allows us to fight with boldness, confidence, perseverance, and peace. And also there can be no forgiveness without his shed blood. Without the shedding of blood, there is no remission, Hebrews 9:22, in whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins, Colossians 1:14. The sins of mankind are so hideous and so awful that you cannot wash them away in the papistry or water, natural water. You cannot work them away with good deeds, even though good deeds are an evidence that salvation has come. You cannot believe them away with religion, and you cannot pray them away in the confessional. It takes the blood of Jesus, and the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanseth us from all unrighteousness. Amen. The blood justifies. All men are sinners, for all we have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. No matter what your particular sin may be or how deep it is, you can stand before God without even the hint of sin stain upon your soul. Amen. When you receive Jesus in your heart and ask him to forgive you and let the blood of Jesus wash the stain of sin away. His blood, we shall be saved from wrath through him. Romans 5:9. The blood saves. much more than being now justified by his blood, we shall be saved from wrath through him. Romans 5:9. Their sinner without the blood of Jesus applied to your soul, you will burn in hell for eternity. Oh, we don't want to hear, depart from me, ye cursed, into everlasting fire. Oh, I can witness, I was on a fast and the Lord blessed me to see one of my relatives burning in that fire that will never be quenched, burning and burning and burning. And the scripture says, knowing the terror of the Lord, we persuade men. This is the good news. Only Jesus can bring us peace. I have learned from being saved, being born again myself, when anything bothers or troubles you enough, it's time to turn your plate down. Because if it bothers you enough, you are not going to have an appetite anyway. There's no greater person like Jesus to fight our battles for us. And he's given us the power of the Spirit. The Holy Ghost will back us up. Oh, if you turn down your plate, if you've got family members that you say you love, then it's time to turn your plate down, because only that can break the yoke, destroy the yoke of sin, so Jesus can wash them and make them brand new. If you say them love that you love someone, then it's time to turn your plate down. If they're not saved, if they're not born again, it's time to lay it on the line. It's time to put all of this armor in action to fight for these souls that are dying, perishing in our family, friends, co-workers, neighbors. Amen. They're all around us. Amen. God opens our eyes to see the need. He's not looking for a dead sacrifice, but a living sacrifice. You don't have to take a big thing. I remember my brother lifts up from time to time, and it's so true. We didn't have peace in our home because there was one sinner rallying, taking over the whole house. Amen. It would have been easy just to cast him out. Forget about him. He deserves to go to hell. And the Lord had my thumb, turned my hand, and turned the thumb right back on me and tell me, if I get it right, then he'll take care of Dad. Well, we joined our forces together. Hallelujah. Had a prayer group of five. I was the fasting warrior. God didn't tell me how long I had to fast, but he knows how much we can endure. It took six sets, 18 days, six sets of three. And our dad got delivered from alcohol. So the same one that was destroying the house from having peace, all everybody else in the house was saved, sanctified, Holy Ghost filled. What was wrong? All fasting was needed to tear down that demon. Time to take the sword of the Spirit and start wielding it. Oh, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, to bring down those giants of sin. If the Lord has delivered us, it's our opportunity for him to use us to deliver somebody else. That takes a sacrifice. God doesn't put us out there on the battlefield and doesn't back us up. He'll be the bread. He'll be the water. He'll be whatever we need in order to get the assignment fulfilled. Oh, just like he's listed for us, all the elements of the armor, the belt of truth, breastplate of righteousness, sword, the shield of faith, helmet of salvation, the sword of the Spirit, and the shoes of the gospel of peace. Well, after the Lord delivered our dad, you know, when you can be separated from God for so long, you don't even know the Our Father prayer. But God deals with the heart. The heart, he brings all things back to remembrance. And we knelt on the floor in the kitchen with our dad, lifted up our eyes to heaven, and the confession had to come from him. Oh, Father God, I've sinned against you. He identified it. I have sinned against heaven, you, Father God, and my family. Take these demons. He identified the problem. These demons of drink away. And we all sealed it in the name of Jesus seven times. And he never took up another drink. Oh, God is powerful, merciful, and gracious. And he gives us all of what we need to do to get the assignment fulfilled. Oh, and the love of God, which passeth all understanding. Yes, he brings that peace to us through the gospel. Oh, joy, joy, joy comes. All of that denial of whatever was worth it, worth it, worth it. Just to see that one sinner repent. Only God could have delivered him. Only God could have delivered me. Only God could have delivered my brother, as we know as Pastor Sheckett. Any of us that are proclaiming salvation, it's the power and grace and mercy of Almighty God. But he sets us aside for his glory. He sets us aside for to do a work. There is no way we can say being truly saved, sanctified, Holy Ghost filled, that we are bored serving the Lord. Then there's something wrong with your walk. There's something wrong, and to get down and serious with the Lord to find out what it is. Oh, the higher heights to reach in him, then deeper depths. And oh, what a wonderful, gracious, great God we serve. Oh, I could give you testimony after testimony on the souls that have been delivered. Yes, it's taken a great toll and many things, but I'm grateful to Lord. He set me aside to be truly a fasting warrior. I could not do it without him. I could not go without my bread and water without him, but he does it, and he protects the temple that he dwells within, and I praise and magnify him. I'm looking for greater things from the Lord. I can profess there's nothing that you give up down here. You never want to look at any kind of alcohol, any kind of foreign substance, because you just want more and more of Jesus, the Son of God, and he manifests his glory through you. His glory through the works he does through us. Oh, to God be the to God be the glory. Yes, saints, let's have our feet shod with the gospel of the preparation of peace. Let's make sure we have those tracts available to give out wherever we go. Whether you're in the car, take a stack of them, put them in the car. If you're just traveling around, just stick them in your pocket. Amen. It'll be amazing. And pray as you go. Lord, anoint this word. Anoint this word that it goes into good hands. Oh, Father God, in Jesus' name. I'm not going to be before you long. I know we have an afternoon service. And to God be the glory. Amen.
Thank you.
Go right ahead, Elder Roy. Go right ahead.
Thank you, Elder Rhonda, for that wonderful message. I always remember now my feet shod with the preparation of the gospel.
Amen.
For those that are listening with us and joined us on our Zoom program today, we do want to extend a invitation to those that would love to come to Christ today. In the name of Jesus, we will have available time after the service that you could remain on, and someone will be glad to lead you to Christ and to answer whatever questions you might have. Now I offer up the benediction for today. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, Lord, in the name of Jesus, we come before you, Lord, thanking you for your goodness and your mercy, your grace that you've made available to all of us, Lord, your love that you've extended to all of us. We thank you, Lord. And now, Lord, as we prepare to leave this particular service, Lord, even though we have another this afternoon, we thank you, Lord, and we pray your blessings upon it. Be with us, Lord. Continue, Lord, to watch over and keep us. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you so much, Elder Roy. Elder Gail, thank you so much for leading us this morning. And Elder Rhonda, thank you so much for such a beautiful word, timely word, in closing things out for the month. On behalf of the First Lady and Pastor Sheket, I want to say thank you for joining us today. For first-time visitors and special guests, we hope something was said today during the service that will bless your hearts. And if you would love to join us for after service fellowship, we encourage you on to stay just a little bit longer. We have some people who are excited about some testimonies they still wanted to share. So join us for a little bit more of celebrating testimonies, salvation, and prayer requests right after this service. And as First Lady always says, don't forget to read your word. Have a blessed week, everyone.
Amen.
First Lady, you can stop recording.
Oh, I wanted to also say, let me stop.